90% of e-commerce stores fail. Now, is your store one of them? My name is Dimitri. I'm the owner of Budapest Media, a marketing agency that works with e-commerce brands. We help them acquire a loyal customer base through paid traffic. Today, we are going to talk about six reasons why your e-commerce store is going to fail. These are going to be six main reasons, as I said, why 90% of the stores actually fail. And without wasting time, let's go right into it. First reason is not building a brand. This is something that my agency is built upon, so creating a brand, creating a loyal customer base, people that actually love the product, love the brand, they're going to come back nevertheless if you put out something that is bad or good. This is one of the reasons why Nike can put out any kind of product that people are still going to buy. Because they build such a good brand, people really love their brand. It's not about those shoes or those Nike trousers or t-shirts. It's about the Nike brand, not the product. As you can see by the statistics of Nielsen study, you can see that 60% of customers actually buy only from companies and brands that they actually bought from in the past. So if you're not playing the brand game, you're just leaving 60% of your profits on the table. As you can see, nowadays people don't want to buy a product because there's just so many and just such a big variety of every product that it's not even about the product anymore. It's about the brand and the story behind the product. So if you don't have that done, if you're just pushing out products on your e-commerce store, if you're not building a relationship, if you're not building a name in the industry for yourself, you're not really building a brand. And we'll talk later about that, how you can actually achieve that point where you just build such a good brand that so that whenever you launch a new product, people are just going to come and buy without you having to actually market anything and without having to actually push traffic to it. Now, the second thing, thinking that everyone is a good customer. For example, if you're selling, let's say, soap, and you think that every person on this planet actually wants to buy soap. Yes, everyone buys soap, but everyone is not a good customer for that product. Now, that is the main reason why you have to do those two points that you see on the screen, which is market research and perfect customer profile. Market research is just, as I said, doing a market research and finding out what is the profile of your customer. So how does someone who wants to buy a piece of soap actually look like? Are they female, male? Are they in their late 20s? Are they even maybe older? Do they have kids? What is their income? So you really have to create that profile, and that's what we call a perfect customer profile. Once you get that, you have to create 3 to 5 varieties of that person, and then you go after that. So you can, with this 3 to 5 variations of a profile, you can actually know which kind of person to target. What is your perfect customer? Because without, you don't know who are you actually your customers and what you are aiming for to actually target. Now, the third reason, not focusing on what your customers are saying. As important as getting customers, it's also important to actually listen what they are saying. As you can see, you can look for your reviews, comments, and feedbacks. This is how you actually build a brand. If you interact with your customers, it's going to build up a long relationship with every single of the customers that you interact with. You can see what they are saying on reviews, on the comments, and on the feedback. You can see what they are wanting in maybe some features of the product, if there are some good or bad things that come along with that product. And you just have to listen more than you speak so that you know what the actual market is telling you about your product. Because there are no better way to actually improve your product and to see what customers want than actually listening what the customers are telling you that they want. So listen to your customers, ask them questions, survey them. Literally, if you have an email list, send out an email right now asking them to list out at least 3 things that you can improve on your store, your product, or maybe in your customer service or customer relationship. Now, the next thing is not standing out. This is also a part of a building brand. If you want to build a brand, you have to stand out of the crowd. Even if you entered a saturated market, you can still stand out with unique stuff. So for example, my marketing agency stands out in the way we actually operate. We are swift, agile, we don't have a physical office. We also specialize in only working with e-commerce brands and driving them more traffic to the store to actually get them acquire customers. So this is what we specialize. We don't go through 10 different niches, 5 different services, and then just like go around that and combining all of those stuff. We want to keep things specialized, and we're just really, really focused on building something that is swift and agile. So that is our way of actually standing out. We actually understand our customers and we understand what our clients want. This is the same way with your customers. You have to understand what they want. As you can see, these are the 4 main ways that you can stand out: is the functionality of your product, the timing, so how much is in stock in what time. For example, Supreme, they launch maybe every 5th or so, I don't even know, but it doesn't matter, you get my point. If you're exclusive, so for example, you're only your products are only available on the 5th and on the 20th, then that is something that actually makes you stand out. So as I said, functionality, time, price, that doesn't mean that you have to play the undercut game. This can also be playing the higher price game. For example, Balenciaga and Gucci play that game of which product is going to be the most expensive. Even Supreme. Supreme has a brick that costs a few $1,000. So that is really showing you how price can make you stand out. It doesn't matter if it's just a unique, like cheap price, let's say $20 for a jacket, or is it just an extremely priced, as I said, few $1,000 for a brick. It doesn't matter, it's going to make you stand out. And the last thing is design of the product. Now this is the product itself, how you actually design it, how you position it. For example, I was just scrolling through Instagram the other day and noticed some unique lamp that I didn't saw anywhere else, where it's a lamp and also charges your phone in the same time. And just imagine how much design actually went into that it made me remember a lamp. Like no one remembers any good lamp that they saw in IKEA or someone else. So design of the product itself can really make you stand out of your competitors. Now, not hiring or creating an A team. This is something that you are going to learn if you're a startup entrepreneur. This is something that you're going to learn throughout the path. But if you're a veteran or someone who has been in this game for a pretty long time, you will understand why creating an A team is a better option than going it yourself solo. So you can see it's not scalable to go as individual. Yes, you can scale to a certain amount, but after that, physically, it's not possible to actually scale. So go hire a team, find partners, your agencies, your other companies that are providing a service. For a better breakdown why you actually have to do this, you can see I created an example of 100 focus points. Now imagine that these 100 focus points, you can use them throughout the day, but only 100 for each day. As you can see, for example, 10 goes to design the store, 40 points goes to order fulfillment, 25 goes to customer support, and 25 to advertising. As you can see, like design of the store is going to suffer, customer support and advertising is going to suffer because most of the points are going to order fulfillment. Now that's going to project on your company. And if you change focuses, maybe you're focused way more on advertising, then order fulfillment, customer support, and design of the store is going to suffer. As you can see, you will have to just sacrifice portions of your business if you want to do everything solo. But let's say that you hire an agency that take care of advertising, then you have these 100 points to disperse across customer support, order fulfillment, and design of the store. Now, as you can see, that is way, way better than actually doing everything yourself. You'll just have way more 100 focus points throughout the day. If you have people that take each of these points individually, then you can focus on the actual, let's say, product improvement or something that is outside of the front end that customers actually see. Now, the sixth and the final thing is not knowing your metrics. It's crucial to know your numbers because business and money is really just numbers and mathematics. So you really have to reverse engineer everything. If you know your website traffic, your AOV, your LTV, and your CTA, you will know how to behave when some of those move, either higher or lower. So you would know that if AOV drops, you exactly know maybe it's because of the website traffic that suffered. Maybe it's the cost per acquisition that went up. So you will know by the movement of these metrics what is actually happening to your store. And you have to look at these metrics daily to always track what is happening, because the one who doesn't track doesn't control. I don't know from where this quote was, but I just remembered it in my head. So these are like the few main that you have to track: the website traffic, AOV, which is average order value, LTV, which is lifetime value of a single customer, and CTA, which is cost per action. When you know this, you know where your business is standing and you will know how to actually improve. Thank you so much for watching. This is it for this quick video. I hope it helped you guys out. Maybe save some of your e-commerce stores if you're making some of these mistakes. If you need some help, let me know, leave it in the comments. I'll gladly help you if you are having problems with some of these points, and I'll see you in the next one.